Good afternoon, students. Today we are going to conduct the experiment on pneumatic trailer. So in our college we have a pneumatic trailer unit on which we are going to perform few circuits. The circuits like automatic reciprocating circuit, then speed control circuit, then pneumatic circuit which involves use of quick exhaust valve and shuttle valve, and the last one will be electro-pneumatic valve. Now automatic circuit we are building with the help of electro-pneumatic valve, so these two will be common. So let us go to the setup. So here we have a pneumatic trainer unit. So here you could see that it's a FRL unit, that is filter, regulator and lubricator unit. Then there's a compressor on the back side of this particular trainer board. From there the compressed air comes to this particular FRL unit. From FRL unit it goes to this manifold. From manifold it is distributed everywhere. Okay, so this is actually a DA converter which is utilized to convert the electrical signal into digital signal into electrical signal, so that this electro-pneumatic valve which is over here, which is a 5x2 valve which will operate. It has got two exhaust port on the downside, because of which it is called as a which is called as a 5x2 valve. Here you could see only three ports. Okay, and now this is a quick exhaust valve. Okay, this you could see that there is a exhaust unit over here, so this is called as a quick exhaust. From actuator it directly comes to this quick exhaust valve, and air will have a shortcut path so that this actuator will have a quick movement. Okay, so let us start. First I'll brief you about the setup. Then this is a simple pneumatic air motor. Okay, this is a flow control valve. So this we are going to study in the speed control circuit. Okay, so let us start with this automatic reciprocating circuit using electro-pneumatic valve. Okay, so first start the supply of compressed air. So this supply has been started. This is converter has been activated. So if I okay, so this is a 5x2 valve. From this the supply goes to the compressed air supply goes to this particular electro-pneumatic valve. Okay, so what I do is that I will shift this lever operated 5x2 valve, manually operated 5x2 valve into one position. Okay, now let us say these are limit switches which are over here. They have automatic reciprocation movement. Okay. So next is our speed control circuit. Under speed control circuit, we are going to use this flow control valve. Okay. Now this air motor speed you could see. So if I open, now it has got certain speed. Okay, now this speed you can change. Now it has got stopped because I restricted the flow. Now if I open the flow control valve, you could see the speed of this air motor is going to increase. Okay, so let us reduce it. Now I would like to show you about the shuttle valve. Okay, So here
this is a shuttle valve which has got two supply lines and one output line. Okay, so here what I do is that I will shift this position, and from here the supply goes to this simple valve. Okay, so this is a single acting actuator. Okay, how you could identify single acting actuator by only one supply line. Okay, so here this is a 2x2 valve which it has. Okay, so I will make sure that this 2x2 valve will remain in open position. Now you could see that if I change the valve position, the actuator is actually moving. So forward movement is because of the compressed air, and the reverse movement is because of the spring tension. So this is all about a use of shuttle valve in the circuit. Okay, so here we have seen all the components which are required for this experiment. We have seen automatic reciprocation circuit, then we have seen a speed control circuit, then we have seen use of quick exhaust valve, then use of shuttle valve, okay, and automatic reciprocation using the electronematic valve. Thank you.